Very good morning, one and all gathered here. So today we'll be seeing about the concept of marketing, wherein when you say the term marketing, the immediate aspect that comes to us is product. Okay, when we think about the marketing of products, what are the different levels of products that are there available in the market? Okay, for example, you take up any company as such, whether they are into product or a service, whatever it is, we focus on customer satisfaction. Let me take you back to the good old school days. There is a concept of progress report, and where they will ask you for a conduct. In that, they would have mentioned satisfactory. When you say satisfactory, looking at the comment, are you satisfied? Certainly not. You will be asking for a very good, excellent, or something like that. But we focus on customer satisfaction. With the term satisfaction, we are not satisfied. Then why you are working on it? You should be able to offer something more than what is satisfaction. What it is? Highly satisfied? Beyond that, you can say customer delightness. Yes, we have to work for customer delightness. What are all the measures that from the part of a management or an organization you will take in order to delight the customer rather mere focusing on the satisfaction? If you could take up the levels of product. Take for instance, you are going to a restaurant or for a Domino's in order to have a pizza. Right, you're in a hunger state, either early in the morning or late in the night. You go there, you're looking for a chicken pizza. Say it should be present. That is what is going on in your mind. That is the core product as such. Okay, look at the menu. It is there. Then your core requirement is satisfied. And after that, you place the order. You go to the counter and you ask them whether it is available. He is checking for the cabin there. And he is telling, yes, it is very much available. Then you find you place the order and you wait on the table. What happens there is customer activity analysis. During the time you place the order and you are waiting for the food to be delivered, what are all the activities that you do and in which way that I can promote about my product or the brand in the minds of the customer is also a research that takes place in marketing. Right? The tangibles that you see, the brand, the logo, or whichever is visible, the table, the infrastructure, everything matters a lot in promoting about a product. Then when you say that the basic requirement or the basic product that comes, you expect a pizza, what are all the basic requirements to be there? That is what your expectation is. It is delivered to you. Then you can say that the basic requirement of a product is satisfied. Then what will be your expectation there? When you order for some chicken piece pizza, when the product is delivered to you, you just have a look at it before you could relish and consume that one. The fact is, you expect some huge number of chicken pieces to be present there and cheese burst to be there on top. When it is there, you can find that your face is blemishing with joy. What you have expected is fulfilled. So, the core product is there, the basic is satisfied, then your expectations are fulfilled. In this case, when you ask the customer, are you satisfied? They say that I am satisfied. But our focus is something to offer beyond satisfaction. So what is that you can do? When he ordered, when you are delivering the pizza there on the table for the customer, you give him a chocolate cake, which is totally unexpected, which exceeds his expectation. In that case, you call it as an augmented product. Wherein it is totally a surprise, but a pleasant surprise for him. Okay, he will be more than happy to consume that and rather relish it. This you call it as an augmented product. Here comes the important aspect of marketing research. Remember that today he comes, you provide him with a chocolate cake, it is an augmented product. But what happens the very next day? You are climbing up in an escalator that is going down. Okay, remember that. Tomorrow, this chocolate cake becomes your expected product. When I order a pizza, he feels that along with the pizza, I'll be getting a chocolate cake. If that is the case, in order to satisfy the customer or delight the customer, you have to think about something else to offer them. What is that you will offer? The future, the outcome of the research, that comes as the potential product. So every day the market keeps changing and you should be in a position to change according to the market and try to satisfy, rather delight the customer in the best possible ways in which you can. This is the core of marketing. You can say whether it is a product marketing or it is a service marketing. they focus on 4 P's in marketing: product, price, place, promotion. When you take up to the services, another 3 comes: people, process and physical evidence. These are the 4 P's of marketing and 7 P's of services marketing. Okay, these levels are common as well as for a product as well as for the service. It is quite unique. And here comes the core of marketing research. And every time, you cannot keep on giving a new product. At last, when you give the bill, what is the price that the customer is bearing for the cost matters a lot. He is willing to take up all the new things that gives him joy and surprise. But the bill, the price tag also matters. You have to provide him something new, something relishing, something surprising that gives him happiness, but at an affordable price tag. That is what the core crux of marketing is there. Okay, I hope these points are quite clear with you. Okay, this is the concept that we are discussing after this potential product. We focus on satisfaction. And let me put it in a simple way. What is the opposite of satisfaction? Immediately you will say dissatisfaction. I can blend the theory of motivation into the concept of marketing there. Herzberg's two-factor theory, motivation and hygiene theory, wherein you take that up, he proves that the opposite of satisfaction is not dissatisfaction, rather no satisfaction. When you ask a person, do you like him? When you say that I don't like him, it doesn't mean that you hate a person. That you neither hate nor you like, it is a mediocre statement where there is no satisfaction. Okay, because when you offer all these things, you ask the customer, yes, I am satisfied. If you miss out any of this product here, when you are serving them, he says that, okay, la, fine, I am not satisfied. It doesn't mean that he is dissatisfied because you have done a lot for him. But our focus on marketing is how to delight the customer. Okay, when you offer all these things, he will come back. Definitely he will come back. But when you delight the customer, he will come back for sure. At the same time, the word of mouth communication, he will also spread it to others and bring his friends and other persons to your business. In that case, a quality of any business as such, whether it is a product or a service, that is depicted through word of mouth communication. Okay, for that, don't focus only on the satisfaction, rather focus on delighting the customer, which will fetch you very good value and for the future sales. Okay, but I can say you that marketing is not only about the sales. It is creating an awareness in the minds of the people that we are offering so and so and these are the facilities that are available. Okay, the product is important. I am not denying that. When you take up the metro cities like Chennai, okay, the product that matters a lot, at the same time the infrastructure, the proximity, even the parking space matters a lot. Okay, the quality is important. At the same time, how you are providing the quality food to the customer matters a lot. Okay, so focus on not only the satisfaction and don't forget about the dissatisfied customer. Because I can say you the relationship marketing theory states that very clearly, if any one customer walks out of your organization dissatisfied, it is like a hole in the bottom of the bucket. The amount that you have taken in order to build the customer base will just pierce through just like that because of a dissatisfied customer. Okay? Now, we used to say that the world of customer. Nowadays, every customer is a world. So focus on them. Don't let any one dissatisfied customer move out. Call them, see that they are satisfied, not only satisfied, satisfied to the fullest, and see that they are delighted so that they will speak about your quality. Okay, I hope this concept is quite clear with you. Thank you so much.